Hello and welcome to special and redefined version of news and entertainment channel Now Vision, the television club brought to you by Journalism and Mass Communication Department, Navratna University. Rather than news, different infotainment shows are awaiting for you. With this, let's start with our news bulletin. I am Muskan Sharma from Final Year Journalism Program, and without further ado, let's start with our top 10 headlines. Law student Maheen from 4th year BALLB, Navratna University, secured second position in criminology quiz competition organized by Raksha Shakti University in collaboration with Indian Society of Criminology. Parvaz Virtual Fest was conducted on 6th and 7th of July by the Department of Journalism and Mass Communication.
The department, the School of Journalism and Mass Communication, has organized this particular event entirely virtually, a digital program. Because that is the way the world is moving.
Navratna University and NAPSWA initiated a national webinar on future of social work on 9th of July. Acting Professor Jem Merchant gave out a web seminar on 24th of July with Career Naksha, a career counseling organization. 7th edition of annual magazine by Navratna University was released on 5th of August. Now let's begin with national news headline. Education Department and Government of Gujarat organized COVID Kiran Physical, Mental and Emotional Well-being Helpline from 5th of May by Dr. Parthiv Mehta, Hansal Bhachej and IES Anju Sharma. 120 traffic signals in Mumbai's Dadar to feature female pedestrian in traffic lights under BMC initiative to ensure gender equality in the city.
In a first-of-its-kind initiative, traffic signals across 13 junctions in Mumbai will feature female pedestrians in traffic signal lights. These include 120 traffic lights between Dadar and Mahim. Part of a BMC initiative called Culture Spine Project in Mumbai, the move aims to promote gender equality.
No age to study. In Kerala, a family from Malappuram district, parents and son passed 12th grade together. In Patna, mother passed from 3-year-old son to prepare for UPSC and secured 90th rank. On National Handloom Day, 7th August, we all salute those associated with our vibrant handloom and handicraft sector. PM Narendra Modi congratulated workers by using hashtag #VocalForHandmade to strengthen efforts towards Atmanirbhar Bharat.
साथियों, 7 अगस्त को National Handloom Day है. भारत का हैंडलूम, हमारा हैंडीक्राफ्ट अपने आप में सैकड़ों वर्षों का गौरवमय इतिहास समेटे हुए है. हम सभी का प्रयास होना चाहिए कि न सिर्फ भारतीय हैंडलूम और हैंडीक्राफ्ट का ज्यादा से ज्यादा उपयोग करें, बल्कि इसके बारे में हमें ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों को बताना भी चाहिए. भारत का हैंडलूम और हैंडीक्राफ्ट कितना रिच है, इसमें कितनी विविधता है, ये दुनिया जितना ज्यादा जानेगी उतना ही हमारे लोकल कारीगरों और बुनकरों को लाभ होगा.
मूविंग ऑन टू आवर लीड स्टोरीज. Breastfeeding Week. The whole country is celebrating World Breastfeeding Week from 1st to 7th of August. This year the theme is to support breastfeeding for a healthier planet. The whole motive of this is to highlight the huge benefits that the world needs. All of this is under World Health Organization and Breastfeeding Promotion Network of India. Raksha Bandhan with trees. Students in the city have celebrated Raksha Bandhan uniquely this year with Mother Earth.
आज रक्षाबंधन का त्योहार है. आज एक बहन अपने भाई को राखी बांधती है. और एक भाई प्रण लेता है कि वह अपनी बहन की रक्षा करेगा। और इसी तरीके से मैं आज इस पेड़ को राखी बांधूंगी, क्योंकि यह पेड़ किसी की भी राखी के बिना पूरी दुनिया की रक्षा करता है। आप लोग भी मेरी ही तरह इस पेड़ कोई भी पेड़ को राखी बांधे।
Around 200 students participated by tying Rakhi to the trees at their home with a promise to always protect them. All of this was headed by Environment Professor Hitat Pandya and Anjali Mahajan, the principal of Sant Kabir School. Also, due to the pandemic, health security of the students were taken care of along with the responsibility towards the environment. On 8th of July evening, Navrachna University celebrated Foundation Day with completion of 11 years of remarkable service towards the society with the presence of Chairperson Mrs. Tejal Amin and Provost Nila Yajnik. The chief guest was Mr. Santosh Desai, MD and CEO of Future Brand Limited. Along with that, he is also a columnist and an author.
Congratulations to everyone on the 11th Foundation Day of Navrachna University. I can see that in a very short period of time, you know, the university has come a very long way and is doing a very impressive range of activities. And I particularly warm to the idea of a multidisciplinary kind of an approach with a social conscience.
The ceremony then led to the launch of Navrachna Center of Heritage Reserve as a mark of contribution to the education landscape and beloved city of Vadodara. All of this was celebrated on Zoom call due to the pandemic.
Ms. Tejal Amin and Ms. Santosh Desai to open the center. And you have to say a yes. So, Ms. Tejal Amin, do I have your permission to open the center?
Yes.
Mr. Santosh Desai, do I have your permission to open the center?
Yes.
Great. So, the center is now declared open.
Oh, lovely.
So, this is the drawing of one of the iconic buildings of Baroda, designed by Robert Chisholm, a British architect, hired by the prince. At that time, the whole idea of social reform was very important. And this is presently the arts faculty of MS University. And we thought it's only apt to use a drawing that has been done by my colleague, use this drawing as a symbol of this center. So thank you, everyone. And we hope to do great things out here. Thanks.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Best wishes to you and all the faculty, your team at SEDA.
Right.
I'm sure that this center will bring together not only students of Navrachna University, but academicians across the country and from overseas over time to study heritage, to conserve it, to learn from it and move forward.
Thank you, madam. Thanks a lot.
Around 87 online webinars conducted by Navrachna University Center for Professional Education from April 17th until date. Several topics and faculties were involved on organizing and delivering these webinars. The Global Virtual Design Challenge, driven by SEDA, is an additional example to the list. They have been uploaded on YouTube too, so our online presence has improved significantly. Faculty also actively participated in the education innovation which Navrachna University had spearheaded in the Gujarat. With this, we come to an end of our news bulletin. Hope you all are safe in your house and pray for those who are unwell and suffering. Thank you so much for being with us. I, Muskan Sharma, signing off. Stay connected, be updated.